Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the energy audit of fans. Previous video we have seen a fan and its types and what are the characteristics and what are the application where the fans and the based on the application we have to choose the fan. The other things we have seen. This video we are going to see the energy audit. That is, generally there are major terms that is available in fans, that is cubic feet per minute, a measure of airflow, and static pressure, resistance to airflow measured in inches of water gauge, and zone, which is a measure of loudness. One zone can be approximated as the loudness of a white refrigerator at a distance of 5 meters, and it is related to a sound parameter. And next one is BHP, that is a brake horsepower, which is called as a BHP, measure of power consumption, which is used to determine the proper motor horsepower and wiring. It indicates the fan's motor size. Next is RPM, that is revolutions per minute, or it is also called RPS, that is revolution per second. It is a measure of fan speed, that is rotation of the, that is rotor available in the fan. Next is tip speed, that is TS, which is a speed, that is speed of a tip of a fan wheel or probe measured in feet per minute. The last term is air movement and control association. The next is if we consider a safety margin, that is the safety margin also affects a major, that is major operation or an efficient operation of a fan. In case where the fan requirement is linked to a other equipment or process, the safety margin is to be decided based on the discussions, that is discussion with the process equipment supplier or the dealer. In general, the safety margin can be 5% over maximum requirement or flow rate. That is, when we consider a boiler or boiler in a thermal power plant, it has several fans. That is induced draft fan can be designed with a safety margin of 20% on volume and 30% on head. The second one is the forced draft, that is FD fans, and the third one is primary air fans, PA. They do not require any safety margin. These two fans do not require any safety margin. However, safety margin of 10% on volume and 20% on pressure are maintained for FD and PA fans. And we will see how the audit can be done in such a fan fans. That is, there are some steps. These are all common steps that is available. That is, we have seen in previous topic. That is a pump. That is a data collection, observations and analysis, and exploration for energy conservation measures. That is in the measures that we have to take. The next one is report generation are the steps involved. And the first one is, let us see, data collection. It is also similar to pump. That is, here there are particulars or parameters for fans, application, make, type or model, fluid handle in that system, and the fluid temperature in degree Celsius, and the density at the inlet, flow rate, and the next is inlet pressure, discharge pressure, all the fan or the parameters or components or specifications in a fan for different fans. That is in a power plant there will be more number of fans are available based on the availability of fans or based on each fan's particulars or components. It has to be analyzed and it has to be noted. and we have to collect the that is the speed parameters, like speed in RPM, type of speed regulation, type of flow control, type of power transmission and efficiency of a fan, and motor in kilowatt, and other motor related parameters, that is year of installation, rated motor efficiency for several number of fans, and we have to compare such data with one another, that is with different type different fans, and then data collections, that is details of fans and ducting system, that is we have to collect the schematic diagram or network of the ducting system, and we have to collect performance characteristics of all fans, and we have to compile that such design and performance guarantee test. We have to make such test previous best and last energy audit values with the respect of fans and a draft system which include excess air, and we have to, that is in general we have to say we have to see a design operating point of fan, that is the volume and pressure, and a normal operating point, that is volume, pressure, maximum continuous rating, low load operation, and ambient temperature, the maximum temperature, the density of gas at different temperatures at the fan outlet, and the composition of the gas, and next like dust concentration and the nature of dust, that is where the from where the dust is coming, that is likewise, and we have to see major parameters, that is altitude of the plant, such parameters and has to be seen, that is some, these are the main specification one of the fan, and that is next is the instrument required, that is similar to pump, here also some instruments required to do the such energy audit, that is power analyzer used for measuring electrical parameters such kilowatt, kVA, power factor, voltage, current and frequency, that is hertz. Next is temperature indicator and probe, stroboscope, slip hygrometer or a digital hygrometer, anemometer, next is online instruments, other digital manometers and pitot tubes etc. are available, are used to calibrate the before audit or during audit, and there are measurements and observations to be made, that is energy consumption patterns of fans and the motor electrical parameters like TST, one of the major parameter and AC component, and kilowatt, kVA and other things we have to see of a fan. The fan operating parameters to be measured or monitored for each fan, that is discharge or flow rates, and the next is pressures, that is so there are different types of pressure, static pressure, dynamic pressure and total pressure. Next is the third one is tamper position or guide vane position. Next is the temperature of fluid handled, load variation and other things in speed and operating hours or operating schedule. Such things has to be analyzed. And oxygen content, flow temperature and pressure measurements across in exhaust gas path, and before and after the air preheater, before and after economizer, and before and after ID fan, that is induced draft fan, and next is before and after ESP, that is external static pressure. In case where flow measurement is not possible, we have to estimate based on mass balance principles, that is stoichiometric analysis, that is stoichiometric is one of the terms available in chemical reactions. Based on that we have to see analyze and energy consumption patterns, that is if the plant is monitoring the energy consumption, it is suggested to record, that is we have to record such energy consumption patterns based on the equipment, that is ID fan, FD fan, PA fan and other fans. We have to see the fan equipment, and based on that we have to measure instantaneous kilowatt and daily consumption kilowatt hour for daily or weekly or monthly pattern data collection must be in monitor or noted. Next is the parameters to be studied in detail are main ducts. Ducts in the fan, that is and the another one is static pressure, dynamic pressure and total pressure, power consumption, monitor present flow control system and the frequency of a control valve, and we have to see the data sheet, that is data sheet for every fan. We have to make a performance parameters for fans, that is date and time. These are the particulars or components, these are the particulars or components in fans, as like pump. And we have to we have to make an unit, that here the parameters have some unit presentation, and you have to have a design value or test value for different fans or for various, for the fans with a different location installation. Here we have to note such values, and we have to make average, and we have to give some suggestions or comment for each parameters or each particulars. Which is also similar for efficiency, that is similar to pump efficiency. Here we have to calculate the fan efficiency, that is efficiency for efficiency parameters, that is air gas flow rate, flow control mechanism and other frequency and duration, flow control frequency and power consumption, motor efficiency and other things we have to see for each and every, based on our requirements, every fan. And similar to affinity law, that is here the fan law is available, that is, and the fan law is given as per Bureau of Energy Efficiency, that is BWE, that is flow speed into speed and pressure into speed square and power into speed cube, that is by varying the RPM by 10%, decreases or increases air delivery by 10%. And varying the RPM by 10%, decreases or increases the static pressure by 19%. And by varying the RPM by 10%, decreases or increases the power requirement by 27%. That is, in the value is cubing, that is, here flow rate is directly proportional to speed, and the static pressure or ordinary pressure, that is directly proportional to square of the speed. And the third one is the power, that is, directly proportional cube of the speed. That is, we will see what is static velocity and other total pressure. That is, total pressure is the sum of static and velocity pressure, and which remains constant unlike static and velocity pressure. Static pressure are due to a potential energy put into the system by the fan. The velocity pressure is arising from air flowing through the duct. This is used to calculate the such velocity. This is a basic, that is a basic schematic or different different pressures available in a fan, that is static pressure at inlet, static pressure and inlet to the duct. The static pressure produces an area of low pressure, that is shown in the figure. Here it is shown area of duct. And next is velocity pressure, and the third one is total pressure, which is sum of static and velocity pressure. And here the flow, that is the fan flow, is measured using a pitot tube, that is, this is a pitot tube, pitot tube manometer, that is, you will see in the next picture, that is pitot tube manometer, which is a combination or a flow sensor or an accurate anemometer that care needs to be taken recording the number of traverse points and the straight length section in order to avoid turbulent flow regions of measurements, that is upstream and downstream of measurement location. The measurement can be on the suction or discharge side of the fan, and preferably both were feasible. The next is that is in the picture. This picture shows how the velocity pressure is measured using a pitot tube and manometer. The total pressure is measured using a inner tube of pitot tube, and the static pressure is measured using the outer tube of pitot tube. When the inner and outer tube ends are connected to a manometer, we get the velocity pressure. For measuring how velocities, it is preferable to use an inclined tube manometer instead of U-tube, that is U-shaped tube manometer. And we will see some calculation, that is measurements and calculation for these things, that is velocity pressure, that is velocity pressure and static pressure and total pressure. Fan static kilowatt, that is which is calculated by Q, that is flow rate in meter cube into static pressure developed by fan in MMWC, that is millimeter weight column divided by some constant value. And for fan static efficiency, fan static efficiency is calculated by that is fan static kilowatt into 100 and the fan total kilowatt, that is Q into total developed by fan in pressure developed in developed by a fan in MMWC divided by 102. Next is fan mechanical efficiency, that can be calculated by that can be calculated by fan total kilowatt into 100 divided by input kilowatt to water, that is motor, that is into motor efficiency, that is efficiency of the motor at operating load, that is operating load, the efficiency is given by into such motor input. And the next is corrected air density, this is given by gamma, 273 into 1.293 divided by 273 plus air temperature in degree Celsius. Next is velocity calculation. You have to see a velocity calculation, that is Cp. Cp is a Pita tube constant, which is around 0.85 as given by the manufacturer. This is the manufacturing constant, which is given at during manufacture. Next is in root of 2 into 9.81 into del P into gamma divided by gamma. That is where gamma is the density of air or gas at test condition. And del P is the average differential pressure measured by Pita tube by taking measurement at number of points over the entire cross section of the duct, which is called as a del P. Next is del P is here, that is del P is the difference velocity pressure in MMWC. Next, in case of gas flow measurement of induced draft fans, where it is not possible to measure the gas flow, so we have to make some other method to found this, that is mass flow method can be adopted, provided the oxygen content and the actual cold flow measurements are available. For flow estimation through this method, the following is are required, that is stoichiometric air requirements, that is workout based on the local composition and oxygen content in ID fan inlet, and excess air, that is excess air can be calculated by percentage of O2 in flue gas in 100 divided by 21 minus O2 in flue gas, and coal flow. And next is fly ash content, that is assumed based on past data, because the present data we can't measure, so we are using the past data. And while in case of airflow measurement for FD and PA fans, the following measurements can be used, that is thermal anemometer, van type anemometer, Pita tube along with the micro manometer can be used, and online measuring instrument. In this video we can't detailly say about such a manometer and anemometer. If you want, you can Google it. And in this fans are operating in parallel. If it is operating parallel, we have to have some parallel operation also. We have to see some parallel operation. It is advised to measure all above parameters for every fan separately to evaluate the individual performance. And you have to have some that is a performance curve for parallel operation. Next is fan performance analysis. That is we have to compare all the actual values with the design and performance test values. If any deviation is found, we have to list the factors with the details and suggestion to overcome. That is investigations for abnormality are to be carried out for problems. And the second one is enlist scope of improvement with extensive physical checks or observations. Next, the third one is based on the actual operating parameters, enlist recommendations for actions to be taken for improvement. If any applicable, like replacement of fans, impellers development, that is replacement. Next is PFT applications. Next is cost analysis with the saving potential for different improvement measures. This is a flow control, that is flow control graph for a different things, that is a recirculation, damper, IGV, VFD and IDL. This is the ideal case. This is a graph between flow and power. These are the characteristics for a fan, that is fan characteristics, that is pressure versus airflow. Here there are some for different pressures and different flow rate, how the airflow is happening, graph is given. And for power and speed, here it is given that the power and speed, by increasing the speed, that is the power required from a centrifugal load also is getting increasing, it is gradually increasing, like power versus speed. And next is visual survey of insulation and ducting system. That is insulation status, measure the surface temperature with the aid of surface thermocouple and infrared pyrometer by using a thermoimaging, and vents and ducting status, source of air ingress and improvement options in ducting system if any, and identification of location where action is required to improve the insulation. And the third one is physical condition of insulation, or the major survey insulation as on and ducting system has to be done. This is by visual things. Next is a study of air ingress into the system, that is before and after air preheater, and before and after ESP and ID fan. These parameters has to be noted, and you have to analyze based on our study, that is past and previous data, that is present and previous data. You have to study, and you have to make some remarks or suggestion or comment. And there are some exploration of energy conservation possibilities, that is improvement of systems and drives, and you have to use the energy efficient fans, and we have to change of impeller with the energy efficient impeller, that is we have to minimize change the impeller, that is change of impeller by a high efficient impeller along with con. And we have to change of fan assembly as a whole by a higher efficiency fan, and we have to impeller derating, that is by a smaller dia impeller. The next is a change of metallic or glass reinforced plastic, that is GRP impeller, by the more energy efficient hollow FRP impeller with the aerofoil design. In case of axial flow fans, where a significant savings has been reported, and fan speed reduction by pulley dia modification for derating, and minimizing system resistance and pressure drops by improvements in duct systems. These are the various energy savings opportunities, or we have to minimize the demand on the fan. And there are many various case studies are available for energy study, energy saving opportunities or energy conservation opportunities. And these are the major energy saving opportunities we have to do, and we have to make some data collection, and we have to compare, we have to give some suggestion, and we have to change. And these things has to be done with the help of some monitoring and reporting using some data collection instruments or the measurement instruments. And this is about energy audit fans. Thank you, and subscribe to the channel.